Ladies and gentlemen, as you guys probably know, a couple weeks ago, I became a certified black belt ninja. It's honestly super easy to become a ninja. All you have to do is make weird ninja sounds as loud as you possibly can.
Kya! Quick kya! 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 Quapa!
I think I just hit my monitor. By the way, the Bessie plushie is a great ninja training device. If you do want to check it out, beckbrojack.co in the description down below.
Kya!
Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. So today, we are back in Zombie Ninja City. We have been training effortlessly as a ninja who flips and flies through the air and does ninja kicks. I honestly still have really no idea the ways of the ninja, but today I want to figure it out just a tad bit more by checking out all the different ninja weaponry that I have available. Now at the moment, I've been using this baseball bat, which has been pretty effective in knocking out zombies, but I think we could step it up today by unlocking all of the different ninja item stores. So we've already opened up a few of the stores, such as the Swift Emmy store, who sells tiger claws. These things are absolutely sick, and they're basically like ninja throwing stars. See, look, I can just throw it. It's almost like a snowball, except it's extremely spiky and it destroys zombies. Now, there is another store over here that I have not opened yet, and this place sells ninja parachutes, which is actually super useful. In order to unlock this store, I need to get some cloth scraps and also some wooden scraps. Click, 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 boom. Clack, 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 clack. We did it! Look at that! Okay, hello. Whoa, you look so sick. This looks like a Dragon Ball character. Paranoid Pablo. Is your first name really Paranoid? Oh, sweet, it looks like just by opening up the store, we have gotten ourselves two parachutes. A good ninja needs no safety net. A wise ninja always has one. I am not either a good ninja or a wise ninja. I am a fun ninja. See, look, I do flips. Now, let's see. In order to buy this, I actually need more wooden scraps and more cloth scraps. So, I guess for now, we'll just stick with our two parachutes. Another thing that we unlocked earlier in the episodes was Strong John, who sells ninja stars and swords and ninja things. I actually think it's just, yep, ninjas throwing swords. Now, I can use this as a normal sword, but it works way better when I throw it and it slices through a ton of ninjas. You guys are not going to want to miss this. I actually don't think I've thrown one yet, but look at it. Look how massive this thing is. The only bad part is that Strong John does not make them super sturdy, so they don't really last that long. And in order to buy more, I need a ton of metal and a ton of wooden scraps. I honestly think it would probably be beneficial to at least buy a couple more. Another shop that I would love to open is a Grunt Love Flare Trader. It really doesn't look like a flare as much as it looks like a stick of dynamite. Now, obviously, ninjas are super stealthy, but every once in a while, we need to use explosive power. For this, I'm going to need some metal scraps on the left side. I'm going to need a lot more metal scraps. Flip! Ninja flip! Hello, Mr. Shady Jim. I need some, yep, metal scraps. When you want 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 more. Thank you very much.
Ninja flip! Ninja flip!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Really?
Flip the ninja!
I'm getting really tired. I think I break my kneecaps every flipping flip. 2 more, maybe? 1, 2. That has to do the trick. Flip, ninja, ninja flip. I'm getting really dizzy.
1, 2, yes.
Now, next up, we need ourselves some magical powder in order to power the dynamite. There we go, just like that. Hello? You look a little crazy. Manic Max, nice to meet you. This is exactly the type of person I would buy dynamite off of. Luckily, he did give me one test dynamite. I guess I don't want to toss it in there, but I feel like I should. Nah, I probably shouldn't.
Okay, fine, I'll do it.
Wait, does it explode? Wait, is it really just a flare? Does it not explode? Did you not sell me explosives? I don't know how that was useful. Oh, wait a second. So if there are too many zombie grunts, it looks like I can actually throw that in order to distract them. All right, fine. I guess I'll buy some. I ran out of metal, so I can't buy any. Fine, I will flip my way back down. This thing could come in handy later on in the episode. There you go. Have my two metal scraps and my magical powder. Boom. We have ourselves
the Love Flare.
The last thing I have yet to open up is the Dragon Cloud Trader. This thing sounds like the most ninja amazing item, so I have it. Obviously, I gotta get it, right? Shady Jim, I need it. I really, really, really need it, and I don't have the materials, I don't think. I have a ton of cloth scraps, so I should be able to fill up this side.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even have enough for that.
What about magic powder? Let's see. Okay, I definitely need to buy more magic powder.
It costs 15? I could buy like 2.
Come on, man. I'm
not even close.
It looks like I'm gonna go have to do my next mission without my beautiful ninja dragon clouds. I'm honestly really disappointed, but as soon as I get enough zombie tokens, I'll definitely unlock that and show you guys what it does, because I'm honestly pretty sure that is one of the coolest items. But our next mission is to go save a supply runner from the police station. Now, it looks like the police station is all the way up in the top right quadrant of the map. So let's go ahead. We'll just do a little bit of ninja parkour over there. If anybody gets close to me, I will slice you with my giant katana. Oh my gosh, whenever I flip, it looks so sick. Please tell me I can make this jump. I'm gonna have to do a special ninja move. The ninja double jump, go!
Yes!
I broke my neck, my neck. I don't know how I broke my neck, but I did it. That's fine. There were no grunt zombies, except for the ones over here. Don't get close to me. I will slice your fingers. I really don't want to have to do that, so we're gonna have to ninja flip our way through the hordes of zombies. Should be super simple. I've gotten really good at it. Now, while we're out here, I might as well also look for any sort of scraps that I can find in order to unlock the Dragon Cloud Trader. Now, let's see. We are on our way to the police station, so if we can find any sort of chest on the way, that would be fantastic. It's getting a little bit sketchy. Plus, there are so many zombies, and this has to be the closest quarter sector that I have been in yet. There's literally nowhere for me to make a mistake. We'll go over here, next over here. I don't know where to go over here. I can't get up that way, or can I?
I gotta do it!
There we go. Oh, we gotta go up here, and then next up here. Yes, dude, I am killing this. Up here, ninja flip, ninja flop.
Ninja flip!
Whoa, okay, this would probably be a good spot to use my ninja parachute. I can also try the ninja star. Boom, take that. I think I got him. Wait a second, do you guys see smoke coming from over there? Is there a person in that building? Hold on, I may have walked straight by that. We're gonna go ahead and backtrack our ninja flips. If there's a person in danger, I definitely need to know about it.
Whoa,
what was that?
Whoa,
I didn't realize that it did that. I do like a mega jump when I jump on those blocks.
Please tell me I can make this. Yes, dude, I can jump so far.
Okay, this should boost me up really high. Yes, it worked. Okay, let's see. I think the fireplace was coming from over here. Oh yeah, look, it is. Oh wait, dude. Oh, we found a lookout point. Please tell me, are there scraps? No scraps, but we did find a ton more love flares.
And I accidentally burnt my toe.
We have to continue on with the mission, though. It says that I need to look for the supply runner inside of the police station office headquarters, so we might as well go ahead and use our ninja parachute for the first time.
I really hope I don't break my legs. Oh, please. Yes, it's working. It's working. Oh my gosh. I accidentally used both of them at the same time, but that was super useful.
Now, if I had to guess, the police headquarters should maybe probably be right there. Then again, I have never been to a police headquarters in my life, so your guess is as best as mine. Let's go see if I can make a really far ninja flip. That was probably the worst thing I could have done.
That's okay. It's all right. I only broke 2 of my shins. I think I only have 2 shins.
This is a perfect shot to test out our love flares on the grunts. Let's just go toss one right there and see. Yes, dude. Okay, they're all going for it. So I should be able to just dance right around these suckers. The only problem is the front gate is completely blocked off. So I don't know if there's a way to go around, or maybe I have to go over. Let's see. Oh, wait a second. Or do I have to go underground to get in? I guess there's only one way to find out. Let's go ahead and use our other flare right there. I should also have a full fuel can, which I can use to power up this generator, which should activate the traps, which they're all right around. All right, boys, I guess we're going underground. This is my worst idea yet. I don't know. Wait, can I step in the goo? I think I can. Is anybody down here?
Oh, wait, this was actually it.
Okay, so we went through the underground sewer system. Luckily, I did not see any sort of rats. But wait, oh, there's no zombies in here. I guess this place must have stayed relatively untouched because all of the gates were up.
Ew, dude, what is this? There's like radioactive goo made out of zombie guts.
Now, it seems like the only way to get in is through the underground area. I need to remain super cautious, though, because I have no idea if there were any police officers in here during the time of the breach. Let's go ahead through this little area. Seems like I should be able to activate the power system right here.
Oh, front gate is now powered and can be opened. Did I open it? Please tell me I did not just open that.
Hey guys, how you doing? I'm not opening the gate. Not today, not tomorrow, not even the next day or the next day or the next day. Maybe next Tuesday. I'll think about it for Taco Tuesday.
So this is where I can go ahead and open the front gate. I probably shouldn't do that though. Maybe when I go ahead and leave. But let's go ahead through the front door. It looks like the main quarters are straight back. Hello?
Nope.
Those things were absolutely disgusting.
This is the perfect chance to use my little tiny tiger claws.
I will tiger claw you. You can jump.
Please don't do that again. That was absolutely terrifying. I never want to see a ginormous zombie lab rat jump towards my noggin. I'm going to have nightmares tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, let's see. We should be able to bop our way up to the top. Where are the headquarters? And why do I hear zombies? How did you get in here?
Ew, dude. We have goo zombies.
I need to get my ginormous throwing sword at the ready. Hello. Oh my gosh, that thing has a ginormous neck. It looks like it's from Monsters, Inc.
Don't do it. I will throw this at your head.
I'll do it. Oh, wait a second. Charge it up. Boom. Did you just eat my throwing sword? Please tell me you didn't.
Do I have more? I definitely do have more. I'm just going to slice you.
That seems a little bit more effective.
Slice and dice. Slice and dice, Jack. Oh my gosh, they actually have armor.
Baseball bat it is. I really hope I don't die.
Ew, ew, ew. No, do not shoot me with your weird goo.
Okay, have them locked straight around the corner. That thing is an alien zombie. You are also disgusting too.
Oh my gosh, how do you have pigtails as a zombie?
When do they have a chance to do their hair? Wait a second, it wants me to go up here into the headquarters. I think we made it. This looks like the briefing room where the main manager tells all of his little tiny police officers what to do. Somehow they busted through the floor.
Tiger claw, tiger claw. I need to explode this one first. There we go. That one looked like it was going to explode.
Now we can also use our flare to get them off me for the time being.
No, I threw a flare, bro. You gotta go eat the flare. There you go. There you go, old man. Go eat the flare. It is delicious. It is nutritious, and it tastes like Fruity Pebbles.
Next, it wants me to go up there, but I want to make sure that this entire area is clear. It's definitely not clear. That is a zombie alien. Should be able to go through the vent system, where I have a really bad feeling I'm gonna run into something absolutely terrifying in here.
That's okay. Nope. We did not see that. I may have seen that, and I feel like this is exactly where I have to go.
Let's go ahead and try our throwing sword at least one more time. It has to be more effective than we thought. Actually, I might not even need to make contact here. We can go up here. It's locked. It is locked. Do I have to go through the ceiling? I can't go through the ceiling. Oh my gosh, it trapped me.
I guess we have to go down, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want to do this. Oh, they're right there.
What is this, storage? Oh my gosh, they're getting closer. Oh, I gotta load up. 3, 2, 1, go!
It took out one, but that was it. I should have sliced them while I had the chance. Zombie scorpion, I will name you Jeff and we can be friends. I'll feed you cookies.
No, I don't think he likes me. It wants me to go through here, up through the vent system again. Okay, I don't see any more zombies. There's gotta be more up here though. Oh, we got a little tiny officer zombie. Let's go through here. Oh, we made it. Find the supplies. There are so many zombies here though. Let's run through. No. Do not touch me. Do not touch me. Do not touch me. Oh, where is it? No. Oh, the staircase is broken. Luckily, I am a flipping flipper. You see, look, I can do flips.
Should be able to go down there and power this generator to activate the traps.
Boop, activate. Yes, get electrocuted. Yes, it's working.
That is exactly what I needed, ladies and gentlemen. That's right. Come to me right into my electricity.
This guy's really dumb. Look at him. He's dumb. Oh, gosh, it turned off.
Nope. Back up we go.
Okay, let's go ahead and drop on our fuel supply crate. Perfect. Right click on it and boom. Mission complete. One mission until my next unlock.
Thank you, Sensei.
Do I get a purple belt now?
Oh, I do get treasure. Let's see.
Oh, yes, I have more scraps. This is perfect.
Wait, another supply run? Okay,
I guess. Wait, Cobra Tower? I don't think I've been to Cobra Tower yet. Okay, I have to go to the old train tracks and continue heading straight. Now, the sensei said, if I can do this, I should be able to unlock a brand new ninja weapon.
That's exactly why I sacrificed my life today. It was not because the sensei entrusted me and he likes me. I honestly don't think he likes me. I honestly think I'm just doing all of his dirty work for free.
But at the same time, I also am getting invaluable ninja experience. By the end of this map, nobody's going to be as good of a ninja as myself, except for an actual professional ninja, because they know what they're doing. But we're not going to think about it right now. We're going to go ahead and we're going to go bop our way to the top and get the heck out of here.
While we're doing that, might as well just go explode some people. Sorry about that, Mr. Police Officer Zombie.
Looks like the exit should be up the staircase. Oh, hey. Hey, how you doing? Oh, this is dead end. Bad. Oh, that's big boy.
Nope. I will jump. I will keep jumping until you guys leave me alone. Is this way? How do I get out of here?
How do I get the heck out of here? It says this way. Do I jump over this thing? What does this do? Oh, there we go. Unlock the shortcut. I should be able to head straight outside and unlock the main front gate. Now, the only problem is, as soon as I do that, zombies are going to rush in. So I don't know if that's the best idea. I think I should easily be able to jump out of here. If I open that gate, it is literally going to open up this entire safe area, which I don't think is the most ninja thing to do. We also have a guy that looks like it's gonna explode down there, and I don't think I can make any jumps, so we gotta go for it! Wait, where is my next mission? Cobra Tower Headquarters. I need to get to a safe spot so I can check my map. Oh, wait, there we go. Cobra District. The sensei told me to look for train tracks, so if you guys see anything, be sure to leave a comment down below. Oh, there we go. This is the train tracks. So he said continue straight from here. If I had to guess, that looks like a Cobra Tower, but I honestly am not sure because the sensei never actually gives me direct directions. He always just tells me like somewhere where to go and I kind of just follow his lead. Nobody is saying that I am the smartest ninja ever, but I am pretty good at flipping. That has to be Cobra Tower, right? That literally looks like a cobra snake encrusted in the middle of the top of the tower. The only issue is, how do I get there without getting overrun by zombies? Now, I would use my parachute, but I accidentally used two of them at the same time. Seems like we do have a super jump right here that I can make it all the way across. Yes, we did it. Flip my way to the top. Flip, flip. Boom, we did it. Yes, okay, I definitely see something over there. Wait, I'm leaving the playable area? No, I don't want to leave. Okay, now we're in the Cobra District. Let's go over on top of this super realistic helicopter. We can jump over here. Yes, dudes, we made it. Of course, this place is overrun too. Don't mind me. I will just give you guys our fruity pebble stick. It is delicious, nutritious, and amazing. No, please don't eat me. Please don't eat me. I don't think they're buying it, ladies and gentlemen. How do I get up there without dying? Oh my gosh, I need to go around everything. No, 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 not today. Jump up here. Jump across this. Jump over here. Hello, zombies. All right, you guys are literally everywhere. That. Take baseball bat to the skull. Please stop trying to lick my toes. I know that they look good, but I am telling you, they are rotten and smelly. There we go. Okay, we have the crafting supply crate. That should be the last mission I need to complete until I unlock a brand new ninja gear. New weapon available. Please tell me it is a brand new ninja katana because this baseball bat is getting a little bit old. A monstrosity? Mutated candy? A candy man? There's a candy zombie man? That honestly sounds like my type of candy man. All right, well, that's not natural. Take petroleum. None of them died, of course. Okay, I do not want to slay the monstrosity yet. I need to go back to base camp and get my hands on the brand new ninja weapon. I honestly had no idea that's what was going to be happening today, but I am super hyped. The only thing I need to do is get out of here somewhat safely. There we go. Okay, I'm entering the headquarters. Oh my gosh, there's a big boy. I fell right on top of him. No. Nope, keep going down. Just keep going down, Jack. Okay, health potion. Don't die. Don't die. Now is not the time to die. Is this the right way? Okay, I think it is. Back in the Cobra District, I should be able to bop and drop and flip my way back to the city. Let's see. Looks like it's directly over here. I really hope I don't die here. Come on, no. I don't know how I barely take any damage. Okay, there we go. The city should be right on the other side of this. There we go. We're back at the base camp. Come on. Okay, let's go check my headquarters and see if maybe I unlocked a brand new weapon. Hello, Mr. Shady Jim. Do you see any new weapons for me? Anything in here? Nothing. Do you have anything in this weird trash can? I don't see any weapons. Are you hiding it in that belt of yours? What about that backpack, bro? I don't think he has it. Let's go check my bedroom. Let's see. I normally collect new baseball bats from up here. Yes, baby! Look at it! A Psy Dagger! Let's see. This does 6 attack damage. My baseball bat only did 5. This thing is way cooler looking, and it's way more powerful. Let's go! Ladies and gentlemen, I think we are officially prepared to start training to battle the monstrosity, which I think will be the first zombie apocalypse boss that I have faced. Now, if I am able to defeat it, I honestly think I should be upgraded from my current white cookie belt to a black belt, or at least the purple belt. We're gonna have to check that out in the next episode. As always, if you guys are enjoying this series, please go ahead and consider slicing the like button in half with your side dagger if you have one. If not, I guess just like slice it with your pinky. Be sure to also subscribe if you guys are new. Turn on all notifications so you guys do not miss out on a future episode of Surviving in a Zombie Apocalypse as a Ninja with Beck Bro Jack. As always, I hope you guys did enjoy. My name is Beck Bro Ninja, and I will see you guys all very soon for a brand new video. Peace out, dudes.